Most insurance companies have what is termed the bonus year of the company, and some declare an interim bonus. A quinquennial valuation is taken by life offices when bonuses are declared and provisions made for shareholders' dividends where the office is a proprietary one. It is true that the holders of life policies payable with bonus pay a higher premium than the holders of life insurance policies payable without bonus, but it is not correct to assume that the holders of bonus policies merely receive back in the form of bonus the excess premiums paid to the life insurance company. If a life office could predict exactly its future mortality experience, rates of interest realizable, and rates of expense, it could fix its premiums so that it would show neither profit nor loss. One of the most attractive features of life insurance is its simplicity. There are no legal costs or charges to be faced. There are no trying and complicated investigations to be made requiring the skill and experience on the part of the principal personally or by deputy. And the business of obtaining a life policy can be completed in the course of a very few hours without incurring a single farthing of unproductive expense. These documents, which are frequently accompanied with a bill of exchange, form the documents of title. If an advance against shipment is required, the documents of title, including the consular invoices, are forwarded to the London office of the bank. The advance should be marked shipping documents enclosed. If a bill of exchange is sent through the bank for collection, any special instructions as to the proceeds should be given. For instance, remit proceeds of bill to London or remit drafts on Paris. Sometimes a charter party is employed, and for all these a captain's receipt for documents is given. A shipper's prices may be FOB, FOR or EIF, and insurance may be free of general average or according to foreign general average. In all cases, risks must be approved by the writers or they will not be responsible for the damage which may occur. In making a claim, the nature and cause of damage must be given, and there may be a case of total loss or constructive total loss. If salvage is necessary, the ship, freight and cargo must each pay its own share of the salvage charges. Consignees may be written to by post with shipping documents enclosed.